I break the back off a cake. Mix some total with this A1D. I zip lock and flip flop. 43, I'm living like a kingpin cause I had clients. The bitches love to fuck with us. Hillside Dimes and I was young.
Man, baseball season's back.
Yeah.
It's back. Sure you're back is. In. You're in. I love it. I know. This for you.
Yeah. Picked the worst year as a Oakland fan, though.
It's a long season.
Yeah.
I mean, they're not going to be good. I'm just saying it won't be this bad, I don't think.
You don't think they'll turn it around at all?
No.
What everyone was talking about before the season started. That's what, you know, like why was everyone so stoked?
I mean, they've been good the last few years. I mean, they've been good, but they're just like Sisyphus pushing the rock uphill, like just like they get to the division series or the wild card game and then they flame out, you know, but what the A's did, I mean, they got rid of their shortstop who was great last year. Marcus Semien's doing a great job in Toronto right now. They got rid of him, but like that shouldn't have been enough to like send you from like a division contender to like the worst team in the league, you know. But they're pitching. They're relying on some young pitching. I do think that Jesus Luzardo, I think he's gonna end up being really good. He was a lefty that threw yesterday. Yeah. Hasn't pitched well either start this year, but he's a top prospect. He's got great stuff. I think he's gonna end up being a good pitcher. Frankie Montas lost last night, I think, or two nights ago. Yeah. These guys are better pitchers than that. It's gonna be rough. I don't know. Like the Rangers look okay. The Angels have a crazy lineup for the division, and and the Astros are the Astros, so like it's not looking great. That's why
they got that fucking shitty combo of like crazy defense with terrible pitching right now, which is hella frustrating.
They're pitching. I mean, it's the pitching.
Like you watch the game and like sick plays are being made, but then they just roast homers into like 500 feet. You know,
you can't defend that or walking guys. You know, I mean,
getting
guys on, you know, first and second, nobody out because you walked a guy and gave up a hit. You know, and then and then all of a sudden you give up the fucking 3-run bomb. You're like, okay, this team's been averaging 2 or 3 runs a game scoring it. Like, and you just basically maxed out your what you put out on offense and you just gave that up in one pitch, you know. So
I
said, it's very early, but starting out 0-1, what did they start out like 0-6? And now it's their 1-6 right now. Walk off win electric today. But you know, hey, I will say with the A's, I'm at the Coliseum right now, if you guys can't tell. So I was doing a little post-game wrap-up with Kipe and Foss. me and Dallas Braden talking shit. But one thing about them is when they're in a tailspin, it takes one just like electric walk-off win, and then they'll rip off like 6 out of 7.
Exactly.
There's no problem. I don't see that with this team right now. What's killing me about them is Chapman and Olsen not doing shit. And like Chapman and Olsen are like, I thought they were generational talents at first and third. Like not so much Olsen, but Olsen's a gold glove. They both were gold glove caliber defenders. Olsen was a 40 home run perennial guy. And Chapman is like, to me, like a guy who could compete for MVP, but they're just not hitting. And they didn't hit last year either. That was a problem. COVID and the Fauci cucked year. I mean, you brushed that off, but you still see it spill into this year and it's pissing me off.
Well, that's another crazy factor, to be honest. Like, pandemic affects everyone. There's lockdowns and shit, and it's baseball players included. Yeah. You know, it's like getting
the libs. Okay, what do the libs hate? They hate like the old Americana conservative stuff.
Yeah.
Why not go after baseball too? Leave no prisoners, I guess. Right. Just take everything I love.
Seriously.
That with the A's. Look, it's been rough. I thought they'd be this year. I thought they'd be like a few games over 500. See what happens type team.
Yeah.
Still can. I mean, it's 162 games is what people don't realize about baseball. 162 games.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like it's a lot. That's a lot. Like, we're not having played played 1% of the game this season. Yeah. I mean, well,
if they won the rest of their games, they'd be the greatest team in baseball history.
Ever. It's on the table.
Yeah. I just don't want them to like give an easy fucking pass to the Astros to go back to you know, to just fucking playoffs.
So you've been reading up on the Astros big.
What I love. Well, I heard about that a while, but I didn't know how serious it was.
It's a glacier. It's an iceberg.
But I love. I was reading like the Wikipedia thing, and it said like, Yeah, the A's were the first to be like sound the alarm, and no one listened.
What happened was Mike Fiers got, I can't remember what happened. Was Mike Fiers was on the Astros? I think he won a ring with them and everything. Had a big playoff performance for him, but they didn't re-sign him. So in your head, the problem is when you're doing dirt, and then you let a guy go, and you're just like, man, we're not bringing back Mike Fiers, and he's like, all right, he did the fuck around and find out, and then he snitched. I forget, he went somewhere else. I think he went to the Tigers after that, if I'm not mistaken. And then the A's traded for him like mid-season when they were on a playoff run. And so they traded for him, and then he just aired him out. Like, I was just a guy, he's in the division, like, whatever. And I mean, but it, like, okay, I don't really like snitching, but like, that's the, like, that's worse than taking steroids to me.
Yeah
Like, because I've like kind of,
well, you're a pitcher too.
Yeah,
you're a pitch, you know what I mean?
No, here's the thing. All right, here's the thing. You want to do the banging on the trash can when a curveball's coming, all that shit, two beats on the thing when that happens. We used to do that all the time in high school when I played high school ball. Like, not that type of stuff, but it was more so, okay, if you were to, like, if the catcher would leave, it's tough to do it on here. Like, when the catcher, right, what they do is they tuck their hands when they give the signs. Like, you're not supposed to be able to see from first or third base.
Yeah.
what the catcher's putting down, right? Because you could relay that to your batter, or have a couple code language. You could be like, all right, let's go, two claps, that means fastball, let's go, or, you know, get a hit now, that means curveball. You could be saying that, and that's how you used to do it back in the day in high school. But that was when the catcher was fucking up, right?
So exactly,
it's like leaving your car unlocked with the key in the ignition, and you get the car gets stolen.
It's kind
of like
a gray zone, you know, but that's on him.
Look, it's frowned upon, but it's like, look, you pretty much set them up for that.
But these motherfuckers have cameras and shit. Like, they were fucking.
Once technology is brought in, I'm out. That's all I'm saying. Like, you got to do grassroots cheating. Is all I'm saying. Like, a real grassroots, diverse movement is how we're supposed to cheat the game. And
I saw the funniest. It was like some TikTok or clip or something of the guy. It was like, oh, gonna throw a curveball, okay? And the guy's got like a trash can. And in the background, it's playing Phil Collins in the Air Tonight, you know?
Right.
And then they're doing that on the trash can. Yeah. I was dying, dude.
Classic, dude. Yeah. They use that same song. Like, that's like a meme. That's like meme lore now, that song. Is because they do it for skateboarding videos. Like, when guys fall, and they'll just do when the guy keeps falling, like smacking his head against the ground. Yeah.
I love that shit. Yeah.
But yeah, so.
Yeah,
but it's been fun. And before I talk about betting on baseball, March Madness was good to me. I net won March Madness, and that's doesn't crazy. Happen. I was talking to our friend COH from the Fed Post. Shout out COH. Mm-hmm. Wasn't a good March Madness to him. He was out by the Elite Eight. He's like, look, I just hope everybody has fun, is what he was saying.
Well, you played some good upsets, but also stuck with Baylor till the end too, right?
That was so the first go round, I didn't do well in the first round of the tournament. Like, I was like, but I hit that big money line, Ohio 13 over a four, Ohio over Virginia. I was just like, Virginia's a choker. Ohio's got some good solid players, so I hit that. Where I really started doing my damage was the Elite Eight. The Elite Eight, I hit all the spreads in the Elite Eight.
Yeah,
so four games.
Damn.
In the final four, I went 1 of 2 on spreads.
Yeah.
And then I hit the Baylor money line for the championship, because I didn't see it with Gonzaga. Look, I'm sorry, Pacific Northwest guys. I'm sorry when you start banging around with Big 12 kids. I get, you know what I mean? This is different. Texas basketball.
Yeah.
Like, Gonzaga is good, and I did predict them to win the tournament. But at the same time, you're like, dude, you guys play fucking Santa Clara University like five times a year. Fucking St. Mary's. And
I know. It's a whole different scene.
Plus, just like, you know, Baylor's got to play, go to Texas, got to play Oklahoma.
Oh, yeah.
And just, it's just different, you know?
Yeah.
And when it comes down to the big game, and Gonzaga lost to or almost lost to UCLA. It was one of the, I don't know if you saw that final shot.
Oh, yeah.
Electric, dude.
I didn't watch it live, but
but just the bank shot at the end. It was like, are you kidding me?
Yeah. And it sucks that UCLA did nothing wrong. Like, they couldn't have, you know what
I mean? They were 11 seed. I mean, they were living off. I mean, that is a crazy run. That coach should have a 10-year deal on the table now to stay at that university for 10 years, because they had no business. They had to play into the tournament.
Yeah.
You'll remember from our last episode, I think it was our last episode, I was saying, like I was gonna bet, I bet Michigan State against UCLA to get into the tournament, and they're like, yeah, no, UCLA won, and so I stopped going against them at that point.
Yeah, I know, it was fucking yeah.
Yeah, so yeah, I hit the Baylor money line. That was good, and then baseball starts.
Yeah, here we are. Yeah,
baseball starts. You're getting into it. I'm like, you know what? Like, because yeah, for me, I was very localized with baseball. I only cared about the A's and the division.
Yeah.
Kind of how baseball has become. It's become that local sport. And before I get into that,
yeah, it's not like the NFL.
No, NFL is an event. I grew up playing baseball. You know me, I was always obsessed. I was a savant with it and all that stuff. But the NFL, still just the NFL experience, you just can't beat it.
Oh, for
what
sure.
I will say about baseball is that it's just that ride or die. You can have a game on in the background. It's the perfect background music is a baseball game. There's nothing better. You just
that's what I've been
game.
Doing. Yeah, I'm like,
it's the best.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's the best. It's like
you pick whatever favorite game was on. You know,
because I hate the baseball's boring people. I go, here's the thing.
Yeah,
we're overstimulated as a culture.
Yeah,
we're overstimulated. Baseball didn't become boring. It didn't. I'm sorry. Like, baseball has been the same product in my opinion. Like, totally. People will say something about the steroid era. It's fine. You have guys that throw 101 miles an hour and guys that hit like 500-foot home runs now. Like, these guys are insane athletes.
Yeah.
But like, the people that say baseball is boring, that's fine. You don't like it. Dude, here's the thing. If you're home, and I wish we had it during the first part of lockdown last year, because like, when you were home, just put that shit on in the background, man. And like, do your thing. Come down. Okay, cool. You got two runners on. Let me watch this. Okay, cool. Boom, boom, boom. Tune in. Like, see what happens.
Yeah. Baseball is the thinking man sport, you know, with all the stats alone. It's just,
I didn't want to be ableist, but you're right.
No, and that's the crazy thing. It's like, it's, you know, yeah, because NFL is just getting so crazy with athletics. I love the NFL and everything, but with baseball, it's just, yeah, you have that combo. You have that those crazy ninth inning walk-offs or 10th inning walk-offs and stuff like that. But then you just have all the rest of the time to just vibe with the announcers, you know, hear some, since 1920, baseball, this is the first time that this
baseball thing. Announcers are amazing.
Oh yeah.
Amazing.
Sure.
Dude.
Yeah. They're the best. Yeah.
Yeah.
Remember, fag capital of the world, dude.
The best. And then he apologizes and he goes, there's a deep drive to left. Oh, he's like, I said something I shouldn't have said. It was a terrible thing. And there's a deep drive. Castellanos gets into it. Oh, my. I'm sorry, but
hanging
it's gone.
Curve. Yeah.
Kind of fag through that pitch. No, but goes back to being homophobic.
Yeah, yeah.
That home run so long. Yeah. But
that's what my dad always told me. It was like, the stats are just crazy in baseball. You know,
I want you to become a sabermetrics guy. I would love for that. I would love for
sabermetrics, dude. That's my
I think you should.
LLC, dude. Yeah.
Brett Sabermetric instead of Brett Saberhagen.
Yeah,
that'd be a sick name. No, I want you to get into that. And then like, what were you hearing about the you were telling me something when we were texting about like almost like an analytics betting thing for baseball. What were you talking about? You were saying something to me. I want to get into this part of it, like for baseball.
But yeah, broadly, I mean, yeah.
I would love that.
Yeah, start like. Yeah, because if you combine, especially like pitching matchups, like you were talking about, right? That's
how you go the first couple months of the season, is you just go off of that name recognition or ride the hot hand pitching. Like, you'd be like, this guy's won his last two starts. I'm gonna ride that till it hurts me.
Yeah,
you know, mm-hmm. It's fun. I love baseball. I pitched like my whole life, like.
Yeah,
throwing in front of people, like one-way mirror type stuff, like people evaluating mechanics and stuff. Like I really did it a lot when I was young. I never had a chance to be like anything crazy, but definitely did it. I learned. I actually took pitching lessons from the guy who was traded for Lou Brock in the 50s.
Word.
insane thing. Like he was the big fish in the trade. Like he was the 20-game winner. They were trading for the minor league prospect.
Yeah,
that was Lou Brock.
What did he teach you? What did he?
Oh, just, I mean, they teach you like crazy stuff. Like you know, you see a pitcher when he lifts his left leg, or if he's a right-hand pitcher, lifts his left leg and he's in that flamingo position and just like keeping your head straight, like keeping that position locked in for like, they'd make you do that for like 3 minutes till your like hip flexors were on fire.
Yeah.
Type stuff. Uh-huh. And like, then, you know, he'd try to get your eyes to wander different ways. And if your eyes wander, you'd lose your balance and stuff.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Like stuff like that. So I always watch pitchers. Like, I always watch pitchers. I always watch.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
Yeah. The art of pitching is incredible. Like, one day I would love to just.
Well, it's crazy to me how, like, well, go ahead. Yeah.
No, just one day I would love to just, like, get, like, a some kind of, like, screen share of, like, watching, like, at bats, and I could just break down pitching to some people.
Yeah.
Like, just people that don't get it. Like, because it's cool when you, it's like a Russian nesting doll of, like, the things that go on in that
game. Oh, yeah.
And other sports are like that, too. I didn't grow up playing them, so.
Yeah. And how underrated, like, you know, fieldsmanship and keeping base runners in check as pitcher is, too, and shit like that, you know, and.
Tempo, just simple things like tempo.
And it's crazy to me how, you know, hitting so hard to, you know, where if you're batting over 300, you're like a Hall of Fame approaching type of guy, right? But at the same time, a pitcher will randomly just get roasted for like 8 runs. That's so crazy to me, right? How it just like it just breaks down.
Crushes
like
the ERA.
Crushes
the ERA.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And then sometimes when you're thinking about signing a pitcher, like a team is like, okay, this pitcher's a free agent. Let's look at his last couple of years. There's even a couple starts where you're like, well, that guy, he gave up 8 runs in that one start. I can throw that out. What's his adjusted ERA if I just say, hey, he had a bad day that day?
Yeah. You know? Yeah. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And it's all different. Like I've even been burned. I mean, even in this betting, like I've been burned where I'm like, oh,
you bet against the A's today, right?
I did. I mean,
I didn't want to say anything, but I had a feeling.
It's fine. You go till they hurt you. That's
I was like, I just had a feeling that they. Yeah, exactly.
I didn't take the spread. I didn't take the Dodgers minus 1.5 runs because that's what every spread in baseball, for the most part, is 1.5 either way. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that's where it gets interesting. And I'll put it on the screen share here. It's let's see. Let's go to the MLB thing. I'm using my bookie. So this is tomorrow's slate of games. Because as of right now, let's get a quick update, score update from our live look in here, our RC live look in. Let's see. We're 2-2, bottom of the ninth here.
Yeah, they're going.
Nobody on. Let's see if we can get this out here, Orioles, and then get a. So I have the Orioles money line in that. That's already good odds. Parlayed it with the under in the Rockies Arizona, which isn't looking terrific for me right now. I just need Arizona to not score runs today. Would be a great thing for me.
Yeah.
No, I mean it's 3-0 Colorado in the third. I have the over under at 11, so I took under on 11. Which hey, maybe they score a run an inning and it's 9-0. That'd be sick.
Yeah.
Baseball over unders are weird. Like your game could be like 2-0 the whole game. You're like, dude, I'm gonna crush this, and then it's just like a 7-run inning out of nowhere. Yeah. Like, okay, well, yeah, now it's over.
Yeah.
But so I'll look at it like this because you were asking me how this works. For betting, and I actually like as much as I love the sport for betting, I was strictly a football guy for a while.
Yeah.
Like so that's I kind of was in this. This is tomorrow's games, and. So like tomorrow, let's take a look. Let's place like a mock bet here. Jake Arrieta is facing Anderson for the Pirates, right? And the Pirates have been stinking. Cubs not great either. Cubs have 18 hits on the year.
Damn.
Hits. I don't know. I think they played today. I mean, I'm sure they got some hits today, but 18 hits on the year. So look at that over-under set at 8.5.
Yeah. Tomorrow. Wow.
Yeah, I mean it's like that's you're hoping for a 4-3 game.
Yeah.
That's how you win that game. Because the shitty part is when it goes extra innings and you have like it's 4-4 and you can't win because somebody has there's no ties in baseball. Yeah. So you just know you blew the over under
Because there's gonna be that fifth run basically.
So say tomorrow we wanted to take the Pirates and we're like, you know what? I think Arrieta is going to stink up tomorrow. You know what I mean? Yeah. I think he's going to blow it tomorrow and I just want to put 10 down. Right. So you see that it's at plus 125. So you can just do this, go 10 and to win 1250. Right. That's why it's plus 125.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So we're going to clear that out.
Let's do it. Yeah.
But with the numbers, let me find a good thing of this. So here, this is where things get really interesting because in the NFL, it's usually like minus 120 for either spread, right? So if the Titans are playing the Jaguars and the Titans are favored by 7 points, if you bet Titans minus 7 or Jaguars plus 7, it's the same odds usually. Mm-hmm. But in baseball, it's different. And I didn't know this, actually. So if I want the Rockies to win tomorrow, if I think the Rockies are going to just win outright, it's minus 115, right? If I pick the money line. But if I think they're going to cover the spread, they're the favorite in the game.
Yeah.
But for them to win by 2 runs, that means this game's kind of evenly matched a little bit.
Uh-huh.
Plus 150.
Yeah.
if I think they're going to win by two runs.
Yeah. You
know? So, so it's like they're the favorite, and usually the underdog is going to have the plus odds, you know, the favorite, right? And if you think Arizona is going to just lose by one, that's minus 180.
Yeah.
Nothing. Like, let's see, what is that when we put minus 180? If we put $10 down, $5 win.
Yeah.
It's nothing. It's like not even really.
Yes. Yeah, bad risk reward.
It's, yeah, exactly. It's terrible risk reward, because if Colorado wins by three, you're like, why did I waste $10 on it?
Yeah, exactly.
So yeah, like I look at like, good thing right now is you look at pitchers. Pitchers are very streaky, right? Hitters are streaky too. But find a team that's not scoring a lot of runs. Find a pitcher that's won its first start.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the way I'm looking at it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So like I said, with the Cubs, I'm looking at this Pirates thing tomorrow. Like, the Cubs are not hitting. I'm thinking about hammering this plus 125
for sure.
You know, like I just thinking about it. So what I've been doing, my method for baseball. Do you have questions? Feel free, like, ask questions if, like.
No, you covered. Yeah, what I was just wondering on. So these are the options for every game.
Yeah, and even look at the over-unders. They're different, too. It's so crazy. Like, over here, most of them are 110, minus 110, minus 110. Doesn't matter.
You can exploit those gaps, you know?
But then you get 115, minus 115. Like, where does that come from? It's so weird. Yeah, like, and sometimes you'll see no spread, and you'll just see money line only. They won't do a half. They won't do a half a run, because that's just winning by one. That just means you won the game.
Exactly.
There's no spread involved.
Uh-huh.
Look, the way I look at it is, like, if you don't know baseball, but you know football, minus 1.5 to me is like 10 points in football.
Yeah.
Like, it's winning by 10. It's a big spread. You have to think that this team is going to flat out just beat this other team. Like, just.
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
You know, because, dude, it gets hairy. Like, like, say you're up 7-4 in the ninth inning, or 7-5 in the ninth inning, and they give up that team. It means nothing to them to give up one run, and it's 7-6 and they win.
Exactly. Yeah. They don't care about the fucking betting.
They don't care.
You
do. That's why you'll see guys sweating, like even in that Gonzaga-Baylor game.
The Dave Portnoy streams where he's just like, son of a bitch, you know? He's
exactly. In the Gonzaga-Baylor game, like, I actually had a bet that I lost in that game on the over. I took the over on that. But, like, that game was like a 25-point game at the end. Nobody's watching it anymore except the people who took the over. They're like, fucking, like, why? You could go to a casino and be like, why are people still watching this shit? And they're like, dude, the fucking over missed by like 2 points. Like,
yeah. It's like another game within a game.
Oh, yeah. It's fucking, yeah. It's wild. But yeah, no, I'm juiced.
How many bets will you take on any given game day, you know?
Glad you asked that. Because I'm treating it like at bats. I'm going 3-4 a day.
Okay. All right.
We'll see what I do. I'm gonna try to be a hitter. I'm gonna be a hitter today.
Uh-huh.
It's been good. It's been good. If I feel like I can at least stay afloat if I go 1-4 a day, like minimum floor 1-4.
Yeah.
And then if I'm gonna go to 4. If I have an 0-4, I'll go down to 3.
Yeah.
The next day. You know, like, that's the way I'm gonna look at it.
Yeah, yeah. I like that. Yeah.
Is that Kelly? No, it's not Kelly criterion, but I'm not putting much on. Like,
then if you get streaky, then you're like, you're way up.
Put it this way, dude. I had 30 bucks in the bag by the Elite Eight, and I'm up to 185 right now.
That's fucking
that's after the Elite Eight and the opening of baseball.
Yeah.
Like, so I just like, I'm doing okay. Like, I mean, it's just been fun. I'll be at work. It's something fun to follow because you get day games. That's the cool. And it's every day, dude. That's the thing, is baseball is every day.
Every single day. Yeah.
Every day there's something.
Yeah.
Exactly. You know, and even if your team's not playing on a Thursday, like I said, if you put a little something, nothing crazy down on these games. So it's always fun. Like that Thursday, I'll tell you right now, that Thursday day game, if you see a Thursday day game and it's your team, let's say you're a Nationals fan or somebody on the East Coast starting at 10 a.m., Glenn's betting on it. I'm just letting you know. Monday and Thursday. Wednesday and Thursday, you see all the day games. That's when a lot of teams play day games because it's the third game of the series, so they can get out of there and fly to the other city usually.
Yeah.
I'm betting on those early games because that's at work.
Do you tweet out what you bet before? Or is that superstitious?
Man, it's not been great. However, the other day, Baylor Moneyline, elite tweet. I hit that. Yeah. I said, Baylor Moneyline, lock it in. I was that confident.
Yeah. Boom.
Yeah.
Done.
So maybe I could have shattered it. Yeah. Could have broke some boundaries. You know, you could say I'm a pioneer in posting your bets online. Rosa Parks of posting your bets online.
She'd
love this. And she would love this. What city was she in?
Was she in Birmingham? Or
they don't even have pro baseball. She's like, I don't care about any of
Alabama?
That.
Alabama? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. I guess it would be Alabama. I'm thinking like New York. She's a Yankee fan or something. No. Big Elston Howard fan, the one black guy on the Yankees during that time.
Yeah.
But inside news, I got my Biden dollars.
Yeah.
And I put a lot of it in Ethereum. Do you think that's a good move?
Did you did it on Coinbase, right?
Yes.
Or did you?
I'm just holding it, buying and holding. I don't want to do anything with it.
Yeah, I think so. What's it at? It's at like $2,000 right now, right? Maybe drop.
Yeah, it went down. It was at 23 when I bought it, so it's gone down. But I'm holding.
I was actually day trading it today, and kind of broke even. It was super choppy. It's one of that kind of jumped into the market, and didn't fully do my research and everything, you know. And
yeah,
it was where, you know, like I would like fake left and it would go right, and I would fake right and it would go, you know, just like that type of shit. But it was cool. I preserved, you know. And but yeah, I think, man, I really think Ethereum, the one thing that Ethereum is, the one thing that's whack about Ethereum is the gas fees. It's for like when you're, if you're, you know, if you're doing all this DeFi shit and you're like swapping out crazy altcoins and stuff, like the fees are crazy on Ethereum, you know. So you'll be paying like,
yeah,
you know, like big players pay like thousands of dollars in fees. So something will disrupt that eventually, and like the tech already exists to disrupt it. But in terms of like popularity, like Cuban's got like what, like 10% of his fucking wealth in Ethereum, right, or something.
So Mark Cuban,
yeah, he's all about it, dude. Yeah.
Sorry, and I'm just writing. I'm doing the writing gift.
Yeah, I think $4,000 to $5,000 is a fair price for this cycle. You know, in terms of like long-term, you know, investment, you know, kind of thing.
Oh, if it gets to that, I'm, because I was thinking about,
and I think it'll hit $10,000.
What do you think about my logic here when I look at, so like I'm doing dumb guy logic where I see the how cheap it is to hold one of something.
Yeah,
I can get there faster. Like, is that dumb that I think that way?
Yeah, kind of dumb. Yeah, I mean, well, it's just it doesn't matter. It like,
right. You know, the gains are the gains, but
cheap and expensive are totally arbitrary. You could buy like, you know, 20,000 Doge or whatever. Right. And, I mean, yeah, I don't know. It's interesting. Yeah. Cause they have all those Bitcoin offshoots, like Bitcoin SV and Bitcoin, Bitcoin Cash, you know?
Yeah.
Which are, you know, people trade them or whatever, but they're like, yeah, my buddy hit me up. He's like, yo, this one's like, Bitcoin's like $50,000 and this one's like 1,000. Like, I should just get this one, right? I'm like, don't do it. You're not gonna make your money, you know.
No.
And it's just because it's cheaper or anything. No, there is something to be said about, like, I don't know, like, first, you know, yeah, because it's all about market cap, right? So you know, a coin's price versus its market cap is really what you want to compare that to.
Yeah.
Like the total, you know, in which is a simple equation, you know. And so if, I don't want to butcher this or anything. You know, like you can have a coin worth a couple pennies with like a giant market cap, right? And it'll have tons of liquidity and all this stuff and a lot of money flowing through it. And that would be like a good buy.
Sorry. Orioles took the lead in the 10th.
Oh, shit.
I needed that. Sorry. My bad.
It's commercial break. Yeah.
My bad. Yeah. No.
But they're playing. Oh, so they're at the Yankees, right?
Yeah, right. Yeah. I need them to hold on. Right. I forgot about the new rule in baseball. Yeah. About in the extra inning. I actually love this rule.
Yeah.
Sucks for pitchers. Terrible for pitchers. But I think it could help pitchers on the free agent market. In the 10th inning, you get a runner on second base. You just start with the runner on second base.
Oh, you do? Oh, is that a thing?
Yeah.
What? An extra. Oh, I didn't know that. What?
Yeah.
Starting on the 10th?
I think it is. I mean, that's what they rolled out last year.
Yeah.
And that looks to be the case because, yes, on initial placement, I'm looking at the score app, on initial placement, Anthony Santander to second. So they place a runner on second in the 10th.
They get to choose who?
I think so. I think it's your last batted out, actually, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, okay.
So the guy like that made the last out in the inning before, I think. I actually don't know the rule on
that's
that.
It's kind of a crazy rule change. And both teams, right?
I think they're trying to not have like 17 inning games, which I understand. Yeah. You don't burn your pitching out. I get that. I get that from a league investment, like in your guys. But I also think for pitchers, if you're a relief pitcher as a free agent, you're like, dude, you see what I did in extra innings? No, I'm saying like when you're time to get some more money, you're like, no, I want $7 million a year.
Yeah.
You saw what I had to do in the.
They're making relief pitchers.
I was the 10th inning guy and I didn't let that runner score, because there is a stat for relievers. And it's the main thing, inherited runners that score.
Yeah.
But when they yank the starter in the sixth inning with second and third and two outs, if those two guys score, that goes against your inherited. It doesn't go on your ERA. That goes on the starter's ERA, the previous pitcher.
Yeah.
But that's how they quantify. It's like, they find the loopholes in that. So
exactly. Yeah. But they're just turning relief pitchers into like DoorDash drivers and like
gig economy.
Yeah, they're gig economy. Yeah, they're just economy.
Exactly.
And all right. Well, you know, we'll give Mike Trout a $700 million contract, and we'll give you like $300K a year, you know, and we'll just, if you don't like it, you know, there's like other guys.
How running backs are in football now too. It's the same thing.
Yeah, dude, that's sad. Yeah.
Yeah. It's, which is like, again, these are awesome positions. Like a relief pitcher, like a nasty relief pitcher, is awesome to watch running from the bullpen, fucking, like got the song and everything.
Yeah.
Like
relief, they used to be my favorite.
They're great. They're great. Uh-huh. And then running, I mean, who doesn't love an awesome running back? Like, what, just a dominant running back, it might not be anything better.
Yeah, exactly.
But like, the NFL's like, no. We'll pay a living wage, 15 an hour, and we may automate you. Like the conservatives that post the memes, like, hey, do you like the new cashier at McDonald's? And it's like a machine, like, because you want 15 an hour.
Yeah.
Like, hey, like, this is Derek Henry.
And it's it's the present. It happened now.
Yeah.
It's
Darren O'Day, I know you're a submariner, but you don't get 15 an hour. Yeah.
Yeah. And,
I'm sorry. That's funny. What you were saying about,
oh no, just how, like the price of a coin is just like a, you know, market cap, you know, that's the more important thing. I'll dig into how that's actually calculated maybe later, but it's, well, that's sick with your background, the way that was.
Isn't it sick? Yeah. I feel like I'm in like an old, like,
just like the regular Coliseum.
I feel like I'm in a 2003 rap video. Like, like those G-Unit videos where they were all smoke. Like, why is there so much smoke? Like, I know why there's so much smoke, but like,
But yeah, I mean, if you were buying like, I don't know. Like, I feel, like Ethereum's hella high now. Like, you know, I said, you know, if Bitcoin goes to fucking 150K, you'll triple your investment, even though it's already 50K, right?
And, yeah.
Yeah. But there are some low, low cap coins that are like, you know, with not a lot, you know, illiquid, not a lot of players yet that will pump like 100x and shit.
Sure.
I'm going to get into altcoin because that's what, like, especially for this show and stuff, because that's what people really care about. They're like, what coin should I buy?
Yeah, Bitcoin,
whereas I'm like, you know, doing
out of
like
the bag on Bitcoin.
I'm doing like levels on the chart and like scalping and shit. That's like where I'm, that's what I,
most
like,
people that have a question for you are going to be like, what's the next coin?
Exactly.
that's like what most people are going to say.
The whole the price thing is just like a myth, basically. Like, expensive versus cheap is
right,
know, arbitrary.
If I'm, because like in my head I'm like, well, I could tell my friend I have one Ethereum, or I could tell my friend I have 0.00625 Bitcoin.
Exactly. Yeah.
And they're like, well, that sucks. You're a bitch. Like, you don't have any.
Totally. Yeah.
Yeah. That's the way I was thinking about it. Shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Shit, man. I mean, you got anything else? I don't know. I just felt like I talked fucking forever about baseball, but whatever.
No. I'll get in this betting shit soon enough. And
something, dude. I would love if you got into like trends and analytics. If you could get into that.
Totally.
And combine that with my, because you could stop me from dumb emotional bets, and that's where I like
it's all about getting stopping the bad bets.
I have that bleeding heart syndrome for some some pitchers where I'm like, no, he's gonna turn it. He's 0-3 in his last three. He's got it today. And you could be dude, he's literally, his average exit velocity per pitch is like fucking 110 miles an hour. Like, he's gonna get torn up.
Yeah.
You know? Like, just, by the way, crazy. That's a fantastic addition to MLB is exit velocity. I love that. People are like, there's old guys that pretend they hate that. It's like, you don't want to know how hard that ball was hit. It's fucking sick. Like,
what's like the high? What's the highest on like a fastball home run?
I don't know. I think Aaron Judge for the Yankees, like, he went like 114 one time. Like, it's just like ridiculous. Like, just like that's like a missile, dude. Like,
I always wondered about. Like, it seemed crazy to me that college uses aluminum bats.
It's nuts. You know? It's wild.
Yeah. But it seemed crazy for a lot of reasons.
Wood bat. I think it should be wood bats.
Yeah. Okay. So so we're on the same page. Like,
yeah, I think you should go. You should go wood after high school. I think you should.
Yeah. Well, it was crazy to me that it seemed crazy that you would play college your whole time with an aluminum bat, then go to the pros and expect to be batting wooden. Like, what's up with that? You know,
dude, I've never broken a bat. Like, that's got to be a horrible thing. Like, when you break your bat for the first time at age 22, you're like, what the hell? Like, just like a murder weapon. You're like, what the hell's happening?
Yeah, exactly. And, but you know what? But just from the skill level alone, like, seems crazy that you'd be using aluminum bat the whole time and have to switch and get used to something else, you know? Like,
if you can hit, you can hit, though. It's not. Now, I will say, like, you'll see. So say you're in the draft and you're drafting a guy out of college, but you see a guy who has like, wow, this guy had like 12 home runs this year, like in this college season. That's pretty good. But then you'll see that they were all kind of, they call them wall scrapers when they barely go over the wall.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, you might think when you see that this guy's probably not going to hit bombs with a wood bat.
Yeah.
So then you don't, maybe not, because the way baseball scouting goes is they do, they have like numbers. They call you a five tool player. You always hear that, five tool player, right? The guy can run, throw, hit, field, you know, shit, whatever.
The whole thing.
All that. They place it 1 through 5, like, or you'll hear plus. He's got a plus arm. He's got a minus arm. He's got a, so like certain guys will be like, well, with an aluminum bat, like I said, this guy's not pounding him out of the fucking stadium. So like, maybe he's with a wood bat, it's not going to be the same thing. I think college goes aluminum, which is weird. And this is going to sound crazy, but I think it's for safety.
Oh, word. Okay. Yeah.
Which is like, okay, but you're increasing the exit velocity with aluminum bats where you could like kill a pitcher, you know?
Yeah,
some of these guys are shred. Like, you should have seen Aaron Judge for the Yankees when he was at Fresno State. Dude, that guy was like a tight NFL tight end. Like, he was like insane.
With an aluminum bat.
With an aluminum bat. Dude, Barry Bonds played at Arizona State with an aluminum bat. Can you imagine what that looked like?
Yeah. They're
like, are you kidding me? Like, Mark McGuire. I think Mark McGuire went to USC. Like, they're just like, You serious, dude? Like, these guys had aluminum bats.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I remember. So Bryce Harper plays for the Phillies. Bryce Harper was like the best thing since sliced bread. Like, when he came out, he was this like, there was this video when he got drafted. I think he got drafted out of high school in Nevada.
Yeah,
number one pick. Like, just so much hype. I think he got to the league super fast. Like, just went through the minor leagues. But there was this video of him at the Tropicana Field, in Tampa, with an aluminum bat hitting them like almost through the back of the stadium. Like, it's just like,
tight.
These guys are too good for that.
Yeah.
You know, like, these guys are, they will like, it's going to take somebody to like die in college baseball from like a line drive.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
For that to happen. I remember like in minor league baseball, there was a third base coach that died because of a line drive. Like, but yeah, I think it should be, but I think the reason it's for safety is because of a bat splinters. And like, there have been injuries where like the side of the bat is like hit guys in the shoulder and the neck. I think that's why they do it.
That's wrong.
But yeah, like, that's like in the NFL, if you're just like, it's a 90-yard field.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah.
What yeah, the fuck? Just, yeah. Or like, I don't know. Like, I'm trying to think of even another like advantage. Like, it's like if they let it be like Arena League football where like the defensive, or where the offensive players could like motion forward and get a running start on their routes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I love that shit.
Remember, you'd see the guy in arena football, like, where the Sabercats, like, where we were at.
Yeah.
Like, you'd see the guy like come from the back of the end zone and then just run like a dig route. The corner's like, oh shit, the guy's gonna run.
I love that, dude. Yeah.
But that's like similar to that. Like, it's like playing arena league football for college and then be like, hey, welcome to the NFL. It's 100-yard field. You can't field the ball off the net, you know? And
kick off.
That's kind of what it is.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah,
that's great. I'm glad you asked that. I had a lot of thoughts.
I was wondering. Yeah, I was like, seems like a fucking dumb.
You're gonna be a wood guy, right? When you
For sure. I just want a wooden bat. I was looking at the website, the fucking Louisville Slugger. The only question is, what wood? Maple, hickory,
I'm a maple guy myself.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a maple.
That's what I was laying. I like maple.
Get that like burgundy one. That one's just a raw color when you get that burgundy bat. Oh, my
raw
God.
Cone, yeah.
Fucking, yeah. Raw burgundy.
Yeah.
And there's a clip. I'll send it to you on YouTube if you've never seen it. It's from the, I want to say the 99 or the 2000 All-Star game when Ted Williams was just like a carcass. Like he was like almost dead.
Word.
But he was like out on the field. He was talking to Tony Gwynn, rest in peace. Yeah. He was talking to Tony Gwynn, and like he just like went, and Tony Gwynn was kind of like Ted Williams, like a disciple of him, for a long time. But he whispers to Tony Gwynn in his ear, and you just like you see this like incoherent old guy whispering, like you're like, I have no idea what he just said. Tony Gwynn's like, yeah, cool, and they walked away, and like a tear kind of goes in his eye, and they asked him, they said, what did Ted say to you? And he said, Ted Williams whispered in my ear and asked me if I ever took a crazy round of batting practice, like 30, 40 rounds, just squaring everything up, hitting it hard, and then smelled the bat after and smelled it burning.
Yeah.
And I said, yes. And he goes, that's the best smell ever.
I'm like, damn.
It's crazy.
Burning, dude. Yeah.
Yeah.
I love that. Damn.
They said Ted Williams used to be able to see the seam. That's how good his vision was. He'd be able to see the seam of the ball that he hit.
He's like, let's go. Yeah.
Special talent.
I learned it takes like a week to make a baseball. Fucking week.
Does it?
Yeah. To dry. Because they use like all these different resins to like let it dry in between each section. Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah.
That is nuts.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That is crazy.
Yeah.
Shit, man. That's the show. I think that's good. Yeah.
Alrighty.
Yeah. Well, subscribe to the YouTube channel if you're watching this right now. This is YouTube only, so just press subscribe. YouTube channel is called Rare Candy. Our Twitter is at Rare Candy Pod 1. We have another podcast. Had some fun guests on it the last couple of weeks. Mm-hmm. Peter Coffin, gay stepdad, all types of fun stuff like that.
Yeah.
Another very fun stuff coming up on that podcast, by the way. Especially if you big fan of the coronavirus. We got some stuff going on there. And if you're a fan, it's a tribute. Corona tributes coming up.
Yeah.
And yeah, he's at Crypto Psi. I'm at Glen Rockney. I have my Raiders podcast if you're a Raiders fan. I mean, hey, if you're an A's fan, you might be a Raiders fan. So I have one called Rock Vegas. That's coming out pretty soon. Draft coming up. Definitely a draft junkie, NFL draft junkie. That's coming up. And that's it. That's it for us.
All right. Catch you folks later. Guys.